Welcome to our special song service at the Kettle Falls Seventh-day Adventist Church, coming to you from Kettle Falls, Washington. And we want to give a special welcome to our friends in Buena Vista, Parkview, and Pinewood. We're so sorry we can't come to visit you yet because of the COVID restrictions, but we want to share with you these songs and special service for you this Sabbath afternoon. We're going to begin with a word of prayer. Father in heaven, we just thank you that things are looking better and we're able to sing and praise your name with less restrictions. And we just think of the people in the nursing homes and whoever may be listening to this program. Just help it to be a blessing to them and help them to realize that you care about them. And be with us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, our opening song, we're going to sing Brighten the Corner Where You Are, number 78 in your hymnals. Number 78, Brighten the Corner. Take a look at song number 85, I Will Sing of My Redeemer. Number 85, I'll Sing of My Redeemer.
From the
cruel cross he suffered for you and me to set us free. Now let's sing number 45. Because we love him, let's trust and obey him. Number 45, trust and obey. Glory he sheds on our way. And let's move to the next song now, At the Cross, number 30, At the Cross. Okay. Alas, did my Savior bleed and did my sovereign die? Would he devote that sacred head for such a worm as I? Yes, he would, and yes, he did. Let's sing about it, At the Cross, number 30.
Such a word as thine.
Jesus died not just to forgive us our sins, but to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And there's power in the blood of Jesus. Let's sing about that in number 14, There is Power in the Blood. When we all get to heaven. Jesus died on the cross to cleanse us from our sins so that we can be happy with him for eternity in heaven that he's gone to prepare for us. And not only that, he's going to make this earth anew. Are you tired of seeing all the sin and destruction of this earth? It's all going to come to an end and Jesus is going to remake it. Let's sing about it, number 47, When We All Get to Heaven.
We are.
Okay, let's sing one more together. Number 46, God be with you till we meet again. And maybe we'll be able to come see some of you in person at the nursing home soon. We look forward to it. God be with you. Share something real briefly with you out of the Bible, and then we'll have one special music piece by Wengel and have our closing prayer. If you have a Bible, you can turn with me to Matthew chapter 10, and we want to look at verse 29. Matthew chapter 10 and verse, well, let's look at verse 28. It says, "And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a farthing? And one of them shall not fall on the ground without your Father. But the very hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear ye not, therefore, ye are more value than many sparrows." You're more value than many sparrows. Does Jesus care about us? Yes, he cares about each and every one of us. But you know that there's something that Jesus doesn't care about? Turn with me to Luke chapter 24. Luke chapter 24, and look at here in verse 38. This is when Jesus was on the cross. It says, "And a superscription also was written over him in letters of Greek and Latin and Hebrew. This is the King of the Jews." And one of the malefactors which were hanged railed on him, saying, "If thou be Christ, save thyself and us." But the other answering rebuked him, saying, Dost not thou fear God, seeing thou art in the same condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds. But this man hath done nothing amiss. And he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. And Jesus said unto him, Verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. Jesus promised him that day, even though it looked like he couldn't save himself or anybody else as he was nailed to that cross, that when Jesus would be in his kingdom, that person, that man would be saved too. Now, did Jesus care that the man didn't have really time to go prove himself or go out and do a bunch of good deeds and show that he was a disciple of Jesus? He was nailed there on the cross. There was nothing else he could do. It was the last moments of his life, and he gave his heart to Jesus. Some of you may feel like you may be in your last moments of life. And does Jesus care, and can he save you in the last moments of life? Yes, he can, and he doesn't care if you have lived a life away from him. If you turn your heart to him, Jesus can save, even in the closing moments. Isn't that a wonderful Savior? I want you to think about that as we have our special song by Wingle. Amen. We just pray that God will be with each and every one of you till we meet again, either in person or online. And let's just have a word of prayer. Father in heaven, we just thank you that you are with us and that you give the gift to our voices to be able to sing praises to your name. And we thank you for preserving your word for us to give us such hope. Through great cost, many lives were lost in preserving this Bible through the dark ages and the centuries after during the persecution, after Jesus died. And we thank you most of all that Jesus chose to come down here and save wretched people like ourselves. And we thank you for the promise that you'd create in us new hearts and make us new creatures. And we pray for anyone out there who may be wondering in this late time in Earth's history, if it's too late for them, that you care about them and you brought them here to watch this program, that it's not too late. And pray that you will come into their lives, accept their repentance, and give them a new heart. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.